First World Order Radio, finally, we are on the air, no doubt. All right.
There's always going to be somebody in the building on First World Order Radio.
We get on into some of that order consciousness tonight.
First World Order Radio every Wednesday, 8 p.m.
We got to talk about what is taking place on the planet.
There's always going to be somebody in the building on First World Order Radio. First, we need to let you know we're going to be doing more shows, giving out more information on Wednesdays. Wednesday at 8 o'clock, we are now going to make this is the hottest day of the week.
Preceding others in time, order, importance. The most prominent parts, voices, or instruments. Earthly state of human concerns in existence. An indefinite multitude, quantity, or distance. System regulates to bring about specifics in the group based on value and natural characteristics. Current radiates electromagnetistics of sound through the air, same as your thoughts transmits it. Preceding others in time, order, importance. The most prominent parts, voices, or instruments. Earthly state of human concerns in existence. An indefinite multitude, quantity, or distance. System regulates to bring about specifics in the group based on value and natural characteristics. Current radiates electromagnetistics of sound through the air, same as your thoughts transmits it.
You need to understand how magical this, something like this every Wednesday can become. So you need to start getting your calendar right, get your schedule right. You need to know our intention straight out.
All right, so, I mean, these clues are given throughout the various languages was to piece the puzzle of this ancient mystery school back together again.
And what we plan on doing, both of us, is bringing y'all some surefire dynamite. We're going to take this level up a notch. We're going to have stuff to do here. This is not just going to be about philosophies and theories. Shit that works.
All right. Back once again. Dr. Dunley Milk. All right. Yeah, we trooping up in the studio, y'all. But we got to give definitely a shout-out to Brother Heavy D. You know, he passed. And, you know, we definitely wanted to give our respects to him. That was Heavy D, Don't Curse. And, of course, you know who was on that track, P-Rock. CL, Smooth, Coogee Rap, Big Daddy Kane, Q-Tip, Guru, you know. So, being ready to get into one of the top researchers in the field of the science of alkaline water, Brother Joel Benjamin. Getting ready to pull him on in. Brother Joel, you there?
Yeah, I'm here.
All right. What you got for us today on the science of water, brother?
First off, how y'all doing out there today?
All right, everybody doing good.
All right.
How you doing?
I'm all right. I ain't complaining.
All right. Well, we definitely want to get into the subject of, the science of this water. From your research, you know, as far as water carrier memory, and, I know that's, something from, I guess, Mona Harrison, and when she was working with the Japanese doctor, scientist, Masaru Emoto, in which that was discovered that water has the ability in order to configure two shapes, sounds, or frequencies. Of course, that's alkaline water, water in which that is at least probably neutral to 7.4, which is blood pH balance and higher. What does your research tell you on that type of on that subject, as far as the water being able to carry sound, or hold or contain the memories and frequencies of music notes, frequencies, so forth and so on?
All right. Well, basically, I went over that on your show a few times before, typical cook could go into archives and check that out, but I'll go over it briefly because there's more than just the water take, carry information and take, you know, shape. The most important thing that people fail to realize with water is your body is made up of over 75% water, okay? So your whole body is mostly water. Parts of your body is mostly water, okay? Way over half. Now, a lot of people don't like to synthesize the water with your aura. Now, the two are very similar. Now, I might have people out there doubting me, but it is very similar. I show time and time again, I always tell people, they could pick up the DVD that I did with Dr. Aline Bay, where I opened for him, and you could also check out Dr. Blair, Inception, the metaphysical breakdown of Inception, where I show my aura pictures, okay? Now, I came to find out once you change the water in your body to a higher vibratory rate, okay, which is the DNA also have water. The cells itself is water, okay, mostly water, all right? That goes for the cells too. So you have to get something to clean out the cells so it can move at a very fast pace to generate that cycle in your body. You gave a DVD, Aline, where you used I believe it was the Our Father, God in Heaven prayer, and the Lord is my Shepherd prayer. When you do that back and forth, you get a motion of up and down, really like a circular motion. A circle go up and down. Just picture a circle going clockwise. All right, people? Now, this is your aura. Your energy of your aura comes in from your left, goes out from your right. Okay? Now, when you take this water, I'm speaking on Kangen water because we already know the basic science of these other waters, which is mostly out there is garbage, all right? Now, I don't want to be mean. I'm just putting it the way it is. When you take that water within your system and it creates that synergy, especially with your melanin, I'm going to touch more on that later. But when it synthesizes and starts going out, because remember, water and melanin goes together. You get, I don't want to just say a newfound strength, but you raise your vibratory rate, all right? They have something when they take a leaf and they cut a leaf and then they take an aura picture, they could still see the aura of the piece that's cut, all right, from that leaf. So what do I mean by that? Say a person, hate to be graphic, but I want people to get a visualization and better understand. Say you have or a picture, right, and you've seen a person's whole body and they have their hand out, okay? Say they were to lose their hand. When they would take aura pictures of that area, you'll see an aura of that hand still being there, all right? All that has to do with yourselves is a projection of your aura, or should I just say straight up your DNA? But better understand so people know straight up, your DNA is a projection of your aura. You have to change the water within your body, the right type of water to put you at optimum health. Because I was explaining yesterday to people, I was taking, a guy asked me about with the aura, and I told him straight up, those digital cameras is garbage. I'll tell you straight up, it is garbage. A lot of people will take pictures with the digital camera, aura pictures, that is, and sometimes you don't see the person's aura at all. That's because the person is dealing with etheric chakras, okay? If they were to take the world with the Polaroid, which is more accurate, you'll see people will have like 6 or 7 orbs above their head, okay? Silver orbs, you'll see silver, platinum, gold, all right? Big, bright, white light over their head, like if it's a portal opening. Now, all these I had in my aura pictures. And as people drunk, the cans and water, they start seeing a difference. When they go to these Asians and get these oral pictures done, the people mouth, their mouth practically drops. And they always ask, well, what are you doing? Your aura is so strong and whatnot, because they're not accustomed to seeing something like that. So water is very important to your body itself. Now, I made sure I broke down, I believe it was on your show, I don't know which one, the radio show I did, but I talked about the frequencies. Now, water carries a frequency. All right? No matter what you program within that water, it still carries a certain frequency. Now, the reason why water is so important, where it holds information, when you drink that water, you're taking it directly to yourself. All right? Now, I know it'll have people, which is just idiotic, and for people of high stature to come out and say something like, oh, well, you could just drink any water, pipe water, whatever. Just make sure you talk love into it. I find that very idiotic and insulting most people's intelligence, because if that is the case, then those people that's out there starving and don't have water in Africa, they'll just take that nasty, muddy water full of diseases, okay, say I love you to the water and drink up, all right? If that's the case, and some people will say water is water, take that water out your toilet bowl and just drink it. You won't do that, because water is not just water. And this is the thing that a lot of people got to understand. The frequencies that these things are giving off will be harmful to you if you don't have the right type of water to cleanse out your system. Basically, I like to say it's raising your God energy or goddess energy. Why do I say that? I'll explain. People who have drunk this water, I like to stick on the females for a while. I notice older women that have drunk this water, that I'm talking about in their 50s and 60s, that had stopped seeing their period years ago. They didn't have their menstruation in a very, very, very long time. Start getting their menstruation. After continual use of the water, some as 2 months, some as 6 months, all right? So what this water is doing is reversing the aging process. Now, what's the science on how it's reversing the aging process? Well, the water is going straight to the cells, of course, and when it's going straight to the cells, it is hydrating it properly, because the microprocessors are able to go directly to the cell. Those other waters, they oxidize the cells, which puts on a faster aging process. So if you don't have a water at high ORP, you're done for. Now, it has water out there, and I will say, or what people will say, to their standards, it's good. But when you check the ORP level of that water, it's completely garbage. Now, come to find out, when you change the ORP of water to a negative scale, it is good for you, because you
have...
All right,
brother, what is ORP for the audience? We need to know, what is ORP?
Okay, I'm sorry. Let me clear that up for people who don't know what ORP is. That's oxidation reduction potential. All right? Now, perfect example, cut an apple or leave it out, you start getting brown, it's starting to oxidize. Same with a banana, same with an avocado, same with a pear. Matter of fact, most fruits, okay? Now, you're breathing in this same air, and let's be real, people, this air is garbage, especially if you're living here in America, with all the chemtrails and all these different things that are being sprayed, okay? So these chemtrails and things are being sprayed. These are going into your cells on a micro-clustered level. So they're going in your cells and attacking your cells. That's why you see in some circumstances, in areas where they're spraying very heavy, a lot of people are coming with the same ailments, coming down with the same ailments, or what I've been noticing, the obesity of some people, they're having that extra pouch hanging over. With a lot of ladies, They're not able to lose that no matter how much they go to the gym. That's because certain unknown substance that they haven't even found on this planet, all right, nobody knows. Well, whoever's spraying it, they know. But the people who's collecting it, the samples and researching it, is stuff they haven't ever seen before. If I'm not mistaken, there's something called Mergellans or Mergellans virus. It has like a gelatin-like substance, almost like a shrimp coming up, poking out your skin. Like, it'll make a big swelling, and this comes out your skin. It's very black. It's like a fiber. But when you hold it under the microscope, it looks like a little shrimp, all right? And that pokes out of people's skin. Now, they did a study with it. From the people that had it, they pulled, you know, it. From what I heard, it hurts very bad. Now, they pull it out of these people's skin, okay? If it doesn't do that, it'll be under the kneecaps. You're starting to see a lot of people, even young people, complaining about their kneecaps, okay? Their knees and their back, your spinal cord. And we already know it's just attacking spinal cord. It's connecting your brain. Cerebral cortex, amygdala gata, your pineal gland, the whole nine yards, your brain. And we already know the brain is 90% water, just your brain alone. So this thing is very important of what's going on. When they take this gelatin-like substance that's poking out from people's skin and this will form under their kneecap and their spinal cords or wherever their joints is and just eating away the joints, they took it and they put it in Clorox. Now, Clorox, for people don't know, it's super highly alkaline on a scale that we don't drink it, of course, okay? But when they put this in Clorox, basically bleach, okay, the next day they had like the beaker stick, you know, the stick that you stir with when you're in the lab. Everything was climbed up, all the viruses was climbed up to the top of the stick and just stayed there. Why? Because they could not handle the alkalinity within that bleach. Now, same with people who have that virus, especially I notice it's happening to a lot of Caucasians, especially out there in Texas. When they drink the congen water, because everybody thinks, oh, alkaline water is the same. That's far from true. If it's not going directly to the cells, it's not really doing you any justice. Now, when they drink this, and this stuff is going directly to the cells, funny, they don't have this virus no more, this disease or whatever have you. Now, when they turn around and stop using the water over a period of time, what ends up happening is that it comes back. It's just that simple because they're still in an environment with the spraying going on, okay? So it's proven that we are no disease is able to survive in an alkaline-rich environment, all
right? Now, So basically we know that the main ingredients in the chemtrails is aluminum, barium, and these bacterial spores in which that, once they get into the body, like you say, produces the disease called Mergellan. You stated, the only way in order to...
It's more than that.
I know it's more than that, but, I mean, these are like the main ones in which that, you know...
Yeah, I'm talking about as main ingredients. Come to find out, they're also putting anthrazine. That's one of the main ingredients in these, starting to put in these chemtrails, because anthrazine calms you down and throws your hormones off balance. So all this is going to the cells.
This is done in order to disrupt the hormonal balance in the endocrine gland system. So to mess up, like you said, the pineal gland, the pituitary gland, the thyroid gland, the thymus gland, the spleen, the pancreas, the genitalia area with the ovaries and the uterus in the woman and within the male, the testes and the prostate gland. So it's purposely being done in order to destroy, and is part of the population control agenda, obviously, of the said Illuminati or said elite.
All right, check this out. Now, I came to a point where I don't bother blaming nobody else because this stuff, Bush signed the paper in order to spray these chemtrails, all right? Now, a lot of people now, before they were spraying, anytime they have to spray, they used to have to notify the people. And if I'm not mistaken, it's still supposed to be like that. Now, I don't see nobody come knock on my door and notify me. And I damn sure they don't.
That was part of the executive order with a president to have the ability in order to do as he want without, i.e., we the people in Congress.
Right. He signed it, but the way how they got it to pass, they look to say that it's to stop global warming, all right, to help block out the sun. In all actuality, which I hate to say this, but a lot of people would not be able to handle the intensity of this sun, and especially with the other different systems coming into play, because we already know the planet is changing. The scientists break it down, so it's just not me from the hood, because that's what people would want to say, but that's not the case. Scientists are even reporting this on a high rate, and they're seeing that the DNA in people is changing. Now, with this sun, a lot of people will not be able to take this sun because they are not properly hydrated, okay? If you are not properly hydrated, you will not be able to handle this sun. Bottom line. Now, also, another important factor that dealing with water is the moon. It's a reason why when people act in the damn fool, they'll say, oh, it must be a full moon out. Sure enough, there's a full moon out. If I'm not mistaken, there's a full moon tonight.
It is.
Okay, very good. Now, these people will be acting wild and outrageous. That's because if the moon could make the ocean on this planet, which is also over, the planet is also more than 75% water, okay? Just this planet. And it's able to control the tides and all this stuff dealing with water on the planet. What do you think that's going to do to your body? Now, this lunar energy, now it sounds like lunatic, right? It always amazed me how that sounds. The people start acting like lunatics. Now, that's because their hormones is not only off balance, the right water is not within their system. When you have proper water within your system, you would be more, how you say, what's the word I'm looking for, at peace? I'll say at peace. You just won't be wilding out. You're supposed to naturally have an abundance of energy when you obtain sunlight or moonlight, not go out in the sun and get tired, all right? Because the water that's existed in your body, when you go out in the sun, anybody that's going out in the sun and they're feeling tired, something is wrong with the water in their system. And if something is wrong with the water in their system, there's something wrong with their DNA. That's a proven fact, okay?
In other words, their body is acidic.
Yeah, their body is acidic. There's no question about it. Their body is acidic. What I wanted to tell you was it's been happening a lot, okay? And at first I thought it was happening like around 2006 maybe. Come to find out this event been happening since 2000. Now, everything I'm breaking down to you have to deal with water, and this is very important. Because they also had it on History Channel, but they didn't go into the detail of how I'm about to go in with it. There's a red liquid. They call it liquid of Kali, the blood of Kali. If anybody studied that mythology, they'll know the breakdown of it. But it's been raining red, like crimson red, basically like blood. It's been raining like if it's blood in certain areas. I thought it was only happening in India. Come to find out, it's also happening in the United States of America, and it happened in Japan, okay? many places this thing is happening to. This red liquid, when you take a drop, you could put the drops together and practically make a bead and put it around your neck. They don't know what this substance is, and this has been happening since 2000, and a lot of people do not know of it, okay? And the people who have talked about it, they're not giving extensive info and detail about this, all right? They're looking to observe this with the whole water situation because this water, of course, will rain in the ponds and lakes and, you know, the seas or whatever, and you got certain areas looking like straight blood, okay? This is happening in the United States. It's been an ongoing thing for a very long time, and you are not seeing it on local news, all right? There's going to come a time where this machine, a lot of people won't just not be able to afford it, but they will not be able to get it. There's a lot of things changing when it comes to water. Water alone is a $400 billion a year global industry. Okay?
Now let me ask you this. So here we have Mona Harrison, who is getting ready to bring us back the science of water from Japan, in which that she was in working with Masato Emoto, you know, the doctor who put forth the science of water and how it carries memory as the molecules, you know, like they did the experiment and they show you can express your intentions within a glass of water and freeze it, and you can look at the molecules under the microscope and its six-pointed star configuration look like a snowflake. That's if you do it positively. If you do it negatively and freeze it, then it looks discombobulated. So she was bringing us back to water. In 2004, she mysteriously died. So what we know with the grassroots movement, we say that she was murdered. And then not soon after, Batman had Angie, who brought us the book, My Body Many Cries, Your Body Many Cries for Water, he mysteriously dies, you know, the same year. So if people don't see a correlation between the science of water and how important it is, then, you know, as Ruth can say, you know, shame on you, you know. But you want to go into any of that, which that we're talking about?
Clear this up. I'm glad you said that. Let me clear this up. This is for the record on your radio show. I am not suicidal. Don't ever have plans on committing suicide. I am in great health, all right? There's no reason that I should mysteriously die. The reason why I'm saying this now, because I notice every time I go on a blog talk show to talk about this water, either the phone cuts off, wasn't cutting off before, it'll start cutting off. I had people that been doing thousands of shows. They said they, as soon as I got on there, mine was the first where everything just shut off, boom, for like a whole half an hour, sometimes an hour, all right? And they have to reschedule the show at a later time. So there's something going on. I don't find that that's just a coincidence that that happens every single time, all right? So Mona Harris was bringing this stuff out, and you have people that act as your leader, and they'll try to tell you certain things. You got to watch out for these people. These are the same people that will go up in lectures and tell you herbs are no good for you. These are the same people that will tell you the water is no good for you, the same kind in water. They'll say they have friends that died. Some of them are doctors that say, will say something like this, and we will look up to them, but they're leading people in the wrong direction when they didn't used to do that. So either somebody got to them, they're scared, or whatever the case may be, or it's jealousy. I don't know. But when you're telling people that you have colleagues that died from drinking this water and everything else you show proof of, but you don't want to show proof in that, okay, then on top of that, you have a culture, an Asian culture that's been drinking this water for over 60 years, curing people with diabetes, people that's on their deathbed of cancer, Caucasians on their deathbed, okay, and they're coming back to life, and they spring back up lively like they weren't ever sick, cancer completely gone, whatever the case may be, whatever ailment they have, completely gone, and you have these people still talking this nonsense. Somebody's leading you astray, because if that's the case, those Asians would have been dead a very long time ago, all right? That's common sense. The people are not getting it, because some of these leaders, they say certain things that are correct, but when you check them out, they ain't saying nothing new. There's so much different things, like what I broke down before with the anthracene and the drinking water, all right? 100 times more deadly than fluoride and chlorine put together, all right? And you don't ever hear none of them talk about it, but yet they supposedly deal with water. Then you have these people that are experts when it comes to the human brain, especially the, how you say, African-American human brain. But yet they're telling you, oh, this water is no good, whatever the case is. But yet you have a Caucasian doctor that's in the same field, and when she gives the breakdown of what's going on, she sees a 30% difference in the people she take care of with ADD, autism, and all those other different brain diseases, Alzheimer's, everything, in just 2 months, all right? So,
you know, that individual we're talking about is Carol Allen.
You got that right, Dr. Carol Allen. Now, and when you listen to Dr. Carol Allen, you'd swear that she just snatched everything out of Mona Harris' mouth, put it in hers, hold it, then wait till you was around and regurgitate it. Because majority of things she says is exactly what Dr. Mona Harris was saying. So look out to see if something is going to happen to that lady, because this is very interesting. Also, I found out with water. Now, you know how the government show that they have certain devices that anybody that don't watch Modern Weapons, start watching it. If I'm not mistaken, it shows on Discovery or History. If not both. Modern Weapons. And they show how they have frequency devices, and when they point it at people, how people start bugging out and they start acting a certain way or whatever the case is. And that's because it's doing something to the frequency. It's doing something to the water that's in your body. The frequency is doing something to the water that's in your body. Now, people that follow the proper diet and drink the right water, it's not able to affect them as bad as it will somebody else. This is a proven fact. You could go check this out. So there's a lot of stuff that's going on that people just don't know about. Now, with this red liquid thing, right, there's been a bunch of downpours occurring, all right, with the red-colored liquid. And it's been several times since, I'd say, about 2000. But most people say as early as 2006, okay? And with this liquid, when they got to learn what's going on, the media, it started getting media attention in 2006. But it's been happening for a long time. This is new, all right? So what I'm telling people is, if this been happening for a long time and you don't know what's going on, and if anything I'm saying about this red liquid is new to anybody, okay, imagine what else is going on, because this has been going on since 2000, all right? If not, probably longer, but it started really getting media attention in 2006. I really want to list a few of the places where this is happening, and you could look it up, and you could check yourself, because most of these incidents, I'm going to give you dates. October 23rd, 2006, Yellow River turns red in northwest China. Just check that out, Google it, whatever you got to do, you're going to find it. And then it happens in China again in April 2000,
Sorry, yes. April 2007. The date was the 23rd. So the 23rd of April 2007 in China. And I believe the way how you say the sea that's around that area where the downpour came and the sea turns red is Ximen. I'll give you the spelling so people could Google this. X-I-A-M-E-N. Again, X-I-A-M-E-N. It's a sea over there in China. The seawater turned red from this downpour. All right? And this happened April 23rd, 2007. So there's a lot of events happening. Now, I want to give you some sources where this thing happened in America, but let me just deal with China first. Also, April 2nd, 2008, the river also turned red. All right? This is what happened. This is what's happening to the water. When I got to find out the water is globally a $4 billion global industry right behind electricity and oil, that started hitting a nerve for me because it's starting to surpass electricity and oil. Because anybody know, whatever you use oils for, you could just use water and convert it with a flow to get electricity, all right? So that could bump off electricity and oil all in one sweep. And it's happening.
So they would soon probably be faking. So probably soon they'll be faking, just like with the oil, you know, that there's a limited supply. They'd be probably be faking a water
shortage.
No,
they won't be faking. Not that it would be a limited supply, Aline. It would be a limited supply of clean water. That's
right.
The thing.
Right.
And if you don't have a superior machine to change your water, the garbage water into superior water, guess what? You're going to be paying. This also happened in Iraq where this river now, mind you, when these incidents happen, these people can't get to drink this water. All right? Because they got microorganisms that have an intelligence off the chain. The scientists are bugged out over there in India because they're researching this like crazy. They have certain areas where they try to lock it down and the government try to take people cameras that's taking pictures and everything. Like, they're going very extra with this thing, all right? So who knows when this thing gets into your system, what it does, because they're saying it's unknown origins from this planet and it's raining from the sky. And I'm talking about no clouds, none of that, all right? So something is going on. People don't know. And it just so happening it's going around the areas where there's waters. Hold on, let me just get this information for you.
All right. Now, I mean, you know, Brother Joel is going in, you know. Hopefully we have to get some questions in here at the top of the hour. All right,
hello?
Go ahead, Brother Joel. Yeah, we back.
All right. It also happened in Iraq in 2008. Notice where I said Iraq, all right? If you Google it and you see what I'm talking about, it would look like they just slaughtered a bunch of people and just poured their blood in water, all right? It also, this is so crazy. This also happened in Antarctica in March 2nd, 2010. All right? Anything I'm telling you right now, Google it. You will find it. All right? They've been trying to keep it a secret for a long time. They're trying to lock down the water and do all these things, and it's not going to work. There's supposed to be another incident in Iraq. Hold on. It's coming to me. Okay, there's a lake in Iraq. It was, if I'm not mistaken, it was June 16, 2010. All right? If the date is not correct, just type in Urmia, Urmia. Well, that's how I pronounce it. I believe the spelling, no, I know the spelling is U-R-M-I-A. All right? This is a lake in Iraq. It also happened there. And again, it's happening where this rain is mainly falling where the body of water is. All right? Lakes, rivers. Now, I don't know if whoever got a hand in this, but all I know, it's happening. And it's weird that it's happening where there's large bodies of water, okay, or small bodies of water, and it's happening directly in that area with just pouring on the water. So I found that strange. Now, it also happened in Canada. For any Canadian listeners you got out there, now I know they're going to put me on the spot. They want to know where. All I know is it's in Canada, and it's a waterfall that turned blood red, all right? This happened September 3rd, 2010, all right? These are events that's happening all over the planet. Now, Aline, did you hear any of these, what I just told you?
I did, about the one in China. But the other ones, the Iran, happening in the United States as well as also in Canada, no. No. Afghanistan,
all right.
No.
Well, I got some more to give you. See, I'm giving it all out tonight right
now. Well, come on, come on. This is what they need. Give it out.
City, there's a city of Varnaz spelling V-A-R-N-A-S near the Port of the Black. That's what the port is called, all right? The Port of the Black. This happened January 14, 2011, all right? These fishermen don't know what to do, and this is an area where they, you know, highly deal with fishing. So this is information that's happening all over the world. I'm going to list some more for you. It also happened in the Iran Lake, the same Umaria in 2011. So this happened again, all right? Now, when they do it, they try to clean it up, like how they do an oil spill, but it's not working. So basically, they try to lock up the area and have people go away or whatever the case is. Now, this is crazy. This is what I don't understand. This happened in a public pond in Australia, all right? This happened on May 11th, 2011. Just type in Australian public pond turns blood red, May 11th, 2011. All right? This is all water. Now, question, what happens to when your water supply turns blood red? Now, you're probably saying, well, was the machine able to handle that or whatever the case may be? As far as I know, I turned on my pipes one day and my water was coming out dirty, rusty brown. All right? I was like, perfect time to test this machine. Turned on the machine. What color you think the water came out? Crystal clear. Test the water. The alkalinity was off the chain. Test the mineral contents. The mineral contents was good. All right? ORP level, off the charts in the negative scale. That's the type of power you want to work with. Now, what people all been waiting for. I know you heard it say, oh, you said it happened in America. Okay, I'm going to give you America. Texas Lake turns blood red, August 1st, 2011. All right? That's a lake in Texas. Blood red, 2011. Then you have the lake, it's called Lake O.C. Fisher at San Angelo State Park, August 9th, 2011. I'm going to spell that for you. Lake O.C. Fisher, F-I-S-H-E-R, at San, S-A-N, then Angelo, A-N-G-E-L-O, State Park, August 9th, 2011. You see nothing but dead fish. Okay? you go and you check that out, you see the whole lake completely red and nothing but dead fishes surface to the top. All right? Now, mind you, when you're buying fish out there for people who's eating fish, you got to be careful because you do not know what this thing is taking in. These people will catch that fish and sell it to you. They don't got no problem. They getting a profit. Also, for the vegetarian, you'll be like, oh, well, I'm raw vegan. I'm vegetarian. Again, I told you, it was dealing with rainfalls in certain areas as well. When that fall on them vegetables, just like they taking and spraying these pesticides, you got that, you eat it, you don't know what's going to happen to you. All right. Norwalk, Ohio. Same place, USA. This happened April 28, 2011. Norwalk, N-O-R-W-A-L-K, Ohio. O-H-I-O. All right? April 28, 2011. This is the whole lake. All right? Again, turning blood red. So this is something where you have to start thinking ahead of time on what's going on. This is not a game. Now, I could even go in with it and give you some Bible verses or whatever it is, but people already know that. When they say, no, the lake is going to turn red, the blah, 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 it's normal now. This stuff is really happening. Now, if you don't know about it, then you better learn about it, all right? Like Australia, March 9th, 2011, they were saying about thousands of dead fish. Now, we heard here in America situations where dead fishes arise or whatever. What they failed to tell you, that came from certain areas where the water just turned red, or they had rainfall or whatever the case of the water, of the rain falling down in that area, fishes dead, all right? And the fishes start washing up ashore. They're not telling you this. They're not going to tell you this, all right? Now, whatever organism's still there, it had areas where there wasn't no red liquid and the fishes just showed up dead. The only thing I could determine from that, again, is with the same liquid, it's just like, as it flow off, I guess the best I could say, it will dilute so you won't see it, but those particles will still be there, all right? And it's not only fishes. It's dolphins. It's turtles. It's sharks. The whole nine yards. Any questions, Ali?
Oh, yeah. You got definitely got some questions. We can get to them right now. All right. Let me get on up here before the top of the hour. And 218 on the line. 218. All right, we'll get back to them. 251, you're on the line. 251, you're on the line. Area code 251.
Yeah, I'm here, Doc.
Peace.
Got any questions?
Peace. I think it's the divine that you just so happen to be talking about water, because in the location that I'm located at right now, which is in Dismal Crypts, they've been working on the water around here for like about a month now. This place called Johnson Controls, and since they've been working on the water, it's been like an epidemic around here where people have been going to the infirmary with problems, like their knees are swelling up and just like some type of pus like coming out of the knee, and some other people have been breaking out with like
everything what I just talked about, basically, right?
Right. I have actually witnessed it, and like me, I'm a strict vegetarian, vegan. And I even experienced it, like, on my back arm. It was something happening. They'll go get you up there, take a culture, squeeze this stuff out of you, put you on some medicine, give you some shots, and then it'll go away. But, like, when I was up there being treated, I noticed that it was, like, a lot of people. Most of them, it was on their knee. Now, the taste of the water, it's changed. It's got like a salty wood taste. And everybody around here has been complaining about the taste of the water. These people still working on the water. And I was just, my question was, is there anything we can do in our position to
purify the water?
To purify the water, because we
okay,
in the terrible.
Okay, I'm going to tell you. I'm going to give you a breakdown on what I said before. The machine that I deal with does that, okay? Now, when you get this machine and you purify the water, you will see a difference and you could test the water. Also, all right, well, if you don't have the machine right now, hello?
Yeah, he was saying he's in a dismal crypt.
Oh, you got to put
I'm
in
sorry?
The
sun. He's in a dismal crypt. So he was asking, like, is there any way in order to help purify the water, because he's in a dismal crypt. So basically he's saying that he's locked down, God.
Oh, okay. Now, wow, that's a hard one. I'll tell you one thing, and listen to me carefully. They have the prison system, all right? Most of the stuff, before they give it out to the population and put it on the population, what they do is they test it on inmates and soldiers.
That's right. All right?
If anything, they'll test it on the soldiers faster. Now, the only thing that I could tell you to help counter it, it won't help fully, but it'll help to a certain purpose, is a little bit of baking soda. Just a little bit of baking soda. And there's, oh, man, hold on. Give me, I'm thinking, because I'm trying to get the exact name of it for you to help you out. L-glutamine. You heard?
Yeah, could you spell it for me, Doc?
Ooh, the correct spelling on that, I don't have on hand. Google it. You know, if you spell it wrong, they're going to be like, do you mean? And then that's it. It's an amino acid. It's
right.
called
L-glutamine. Right, G-L-U-T-O-M-I-N-E, glutamine.
Yeah, L-glutamine.
G-L-U-T-O-M-I-N-E, glutamine.
Okay,
just spell
I got it
the best way you know how. Now, I'm going to give you a herb that you could take, which I also deal with because I make certain drinks or whatever, okay? And I'll give you one of the ingredients where you can help yourself if you can get your hands on it. And if you get your hands on it, make sure it's very potent. It's called reishi mushroom.
Reishi mushroom.
Yes.
R-E-I-S-H-I. That's R-E-I-S-H-I. Reishi mushroom.
Alright.
Now what that reishi mushroom would do, now this is crazy, because I was using it and I had to stop taking it at one point, and then I started back taking it.
Okay.
It burns up the virus that's in your blood. You'll notice you'll start sweating, or how you say, you get a burst of energy. That's because your blood is flowing. It's doing something to your blood. Also, there's an article, and not for nothing I could find this article. I had this article since 2005. I looked it up online, where they did a study on how the monks were trying to use their stuff to use their meditations to levitate, and they will take high amounts of reishi mushroom because there's something to do to the water in their body, also the blood, of course. And what did this stuff do? It makes your blood in your body lighter. The most thing I could say, other people that did research still not able to tell what it does. You will be a big person, and when you go in and pull up bars, you'll literally think that you're a feather. I had to stop using it because I wasn't feeling the burn that I needed to feel to cause the resistance so my muscles could get bigger. I was just on the stuff until I started doing it with one hand, on a pull-up bar with one hand, just pulling up. All right? It's something it does to the water within your body and the blood. It makes the blood lighter. How the scientific effects that it does that, I don't know. All scientists that do know is that it happens. I tried to find that article, and I am not able to find it at all. But those are the best things that I know that you could possibly do for the, your situation and what's going on. And if it's happening in that area, a prison or a military base, bet your bottom dollar it's happening outside in the area where other people are living. Guaranteed. Anything else?
Oh, yeah, no doubt about it. No doubt about it. We got another call here. Thank you, brother. We going to area code 251. Area code 251, you on the line. Oh. You have any more questions or comments?
Oh, that was good, that bro. I showed that was peace.
All right. Peace, brother.
Peace.
All right. We got area code 910. Area code 910.
Peace, peace, Ark.
Peace.
All right. Peace, hey, I wanted to know how do I get the alkaline water with the ORP? And is there the gentleman was speaking of a machine that can purify your water for you? How do I obtain that?
All right. Well, I'll give you my number. I'm getting my number out right now. 347-595-3847.
Okay.
Aline, get them your wife's number, please.
And that number is,
Aline.
Of course, yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Yep, and that number is, that number is 252-257-3588. That's 252-257-3588.
Or if you're in the Maryland area, you can call Sister Paulette, 443-844-1695. Thank you so much, Wednesday, for your question.
Those are three sources where you can get this stuff from, okay? So if you're not able to afford a machine, you're down south, Khadija could provide it for you. You're in the Maryland area, Paulette could provide it for you. And if you're in the New York area, I could provide it for you. If you have any questions for them, whatever they don't know, they will refer you to me. I'll tell you what you need to know and set you on the way that you need to go.
Okay, I appreciate that. Thank you very much.
Before I finish, because I know they got some people that's very religious out there, I just want to give a breakdown. Because some people be like, oh, do away with the Bible, especially a lot of people in the conscious community. I don't know what's going on with them. It has a lot of stuff in there that's, you know, very groundbreaking and that you could learn a lot of stuff from. This comes from the Bible, Revelation 16, all right? If I'm not mistaken, third verse. And it says, the second angel poured out his bowl on the sea. And it turned into blood like that of dead men. And every living thing in the sea died. The third angel poured out his bowl on the rivers and springs of water, and they became blood. Then I heard the angel in charge of the waters say, now, I'm going to repeat this because a lot of people don't pay attention when they're reading these things and look and get correlations of what's happening now in this time, in this event, to understand. I'm going to read that last part again. Then I heard the angel in charge, okay, of the waters say, you are just in these judgments, you who are and who were the Holy One, because you have so judged, for they have shed the blood of your saints and prophets and you have given them blood to drink as they deserve. And I heard the altar respond, yes, Lord God Almighty, true and just are your judgments. Now, that's in the Bible, all right? They even talk about an angel of water. That one went over my head until something happened and, you know, it just directed me to go to that spot and I got it. I didn't even know there was an angel of water, all right? So this is just for those people who want to do a lecture on that and break down into the metaphysics or whatever have you, you could. Again,
but Nigel, we're going to leave that to you. Right now, you playing that part.
Well, I guess I am, right? Because
exactly.
I know the earliest, like, occurrence of this rain pouring was July 25th to September 23rd, 2001. All right? People saying it's a phenomenon, but it's like, whatever. It's a regular thing now. It's happening too often in too many places, okay? So people got to start getting their water in order, because water, if anybody seen Water World, now, I don't know if it's going to be like that where the world is flooded with water, but there's not enough clean water, so they're fighting and killing for clean water. But I'll tell you one thing, there will be fighting and killing for clean water. I could guarantee that. I ain't no fear monger. I ain't trying to put fear in nobody. It's just the truth. Like they say.
Well, bro, you didn't write the Bible, you know, not that I know of anyway. So,
no.
Nobody can say something, of that magnitude of ignorance or stupidity. But what we can say is that right now, that an angel is a thought of Allah garbed in flesh. And right now, like I said, you might be playing that part of the angel of water, being that right now, as far as I'm concerned, you're the foremost authority on the water aspects as far as the science and the metaphysics and the research of it and the reason why we need to be drinking the proper water right now at this particular time. And everything is concurrent and correlating and coinciding at this particular time. I mean, we're talking about 2011. You know, 2011 going into 2012, we're just talking about just a week and a half ago. We're talking about the end of the Mayan calendar, October the 28th, you know, on some aspects. And everything was that you spoke about been happening, like you said, for the last 10 to 11 years or so, as far as articles are concerned, and them actually putting it out and getting it out, you know, into the public, and more so by 2006. So, you know, for the last 5 years, especially. So, I mean, right now, we're the bearers of this, you know, of this new age in which that is coming up. And like you said, they fear these solar flare activities, because this goes back to Malachi, the fourth chapter, the second verse, where it says that the Son of Righteousness will come with healing in his wings, in which that a day will come where the wicked shall be burnt as an oven. So we know that the Son is going to play a major part in the recalibrating of this planet Earth and shedding forth of these viruses, said reptilians or reptilian-minded beings who can't make the transition from the third into the fifth dimension, as the indigenous people talk about. This water will help you make that transition. It will at least recalibrate your cellular structure where life and death begins at, is in the cells. All right?
Okay, how you doing, Paulette?
Pretty good. I have a couple of comments to make for all those people out there that are interested in the water. I have a testimony. One is for my significant other. He had problems with arthritis in both of his knees, but one particular knee, I think, was the right one, that he had more pain than the other. And when he started drinking the water, he's been drinking the water for about maybe 2 weeks now. He does not feel any pain at all. And every day I ask him, I said, well, how's your knee doing? He says, well, I don't feel any pain. So evidently must be doing okay. And the other thing is that Joel was able to give him some of the herbs that he makes up because he was having a erection dysfunction. And after Joel gave him the herbs for that situation, it was a done deal. It was solved. So his herbs
yes,
are great.
That's a drink I make.
Yeah. Oh, yes, his herbs are great to drink, and the water is excellent for optimum health. So if you're not on the water, I suggest very strongly that you get on the water because it will do your body justice and put you in optimum health. So those are my comments that I had to make.
Yeah,
Paulette,
you so
on point. You on point with that. After the police whooped my tail, my hip hurt, and the cans
mm-hmm.
of water, I don't have no pain. So I'm
none
I'm,
whatsoever.
Testimonies. We testimonies, and you better believe that police officer gonna feel that worse than I did.
Mm-hmm.
I do want to just quickly, Joelle, just please, Paula, if you would just add on with the amber energy for those people who are. And I know it's off the subject, but we still need to get you in the plug in. This is a commercial.
Okay. Oh, okay. For those that may not know, Amber Energy is a supplier. As you know, a lot of the energy companies now have to give one of their services to a supplier company now. And there are quite a few companies out here. But Amber Energy is in states like New York, New Jersey, Maryland, Pennsylvania, Texas, and Chicago, Illinois. And what we do is that we allow you to earn free energy. Eliminate your bill completely and have free energy for the rest of your life, along with giving you an incentive for a vacation. You join, there is no fee, no termination fee. You get nothing but savings, and we give satisfaction guarantee. And the other thing I wanted to say is that we give up to 30% discount off of your electric bill and sometimes even more. So if you're interested in becoming a customer or a consultant, you can see me, call me at 443-844-1695, 443-844-1695. Now, you do not have to live in any of the states that I mentioned, but if you know people that live there, you can give them my information, or you can become a consultant if you like, just by knowing people in other places to make income. So it's a great opportunity for a business. And thank you,
yes,
sister and brother.
Yes, it is. Paulette needs a couple more family members. It's free to sign over. If your bill is $100, then you'll only be paying $66. So please help the goddess out. Thank you so much, Paulette, and you have a wonderful
thank
night.
Thank you. You too. Still listening, though.
Okay.
All right, Brother Joel, before we get into those individuals saying certain things about the water, let's get to your herbal blends with the water. I think that would be probably more beneficial for the audience as far as, you know, the signs of herbs and the type of water that they need with the herbs, because most are drinking tap water or either bottled water, you know, taking herbs and thinking that they're getting a full benefit. What you have to say about that?
You see, you done got me sorted because I'm still going to correlate the two within each other. Why? Because they have people out there that's dealing with these herbs, and they're telling you get the herbs, but none of them is telling you the proper water to drink. It's an oxymoron. You take Poland Spring, Dasani, and all these things and mix them with these good herbs and put that in your system. And the herbs, yeah, going in your system, but it'll take longer to affect while you're buying these herbs from them, and they just keep on making more money. That's just the bottom line. It's about money with most of these people. Now, some of the herbs that I have is basically, I also make sure I get organic, hard-to-find herbs, herbs that people haven't even heard the name of, like Viridasha. A lot of people haven't even heard of it. Long, it's like probably 16 letters in that spelling just alone. What I learned, when you have proper water that's
ionized properly, where you got the microcluster smaller than your actual cells, it takes more out of the herb and puts it into your system. So once you have something that you're working with that's properly strong, potent herbs, you spend the extra money. It's expensive, but it's worth it. You spend that extra money and you make up a formula, you'll be good to go. But you have to use the proper water.
The average person spends over $200 a month if they have some bottled water anyway. So, you know, compare that, you know, the Kangen water or the Kangen water to, you know, the major water suppliers like you said, Dasani, Aquafina, Poland Springs, you know, how do they rate as compared to the ORP levels and as far as the alkalinity?
Well, first of all, when you say Dasani and Poland Spring, you got to think of Pepsi and Coca-Cola. Because these
right.
are the people that's pushing this thing, all right? The alkalinity of those is garbage. I'm not even going to get into that. They could watch the DVD. You got the DVD on that. They could watch the Avatar 2012. They could watch the metaphysical breakdown of Inception, where I go through all that. It's a simple pH test I do. Those water are garbage, even down to Fiji, okay? Even Fiji water is garbage. And I gave the breakdown of Fiji water already, how the people of the Fiji island can't even drink their own water. If they go near that, they'll get shot. This was in Mother Times, newspaper, something like that. I already gave out that information, so people could go to the archives and check that out. Now, back to this alkalinity thing. It's very important for people to understand. You have alkaline water out there like Evermore and all these that claims to be 9.5, which could be true. But again, if it's not going directly to the cells to properly hydrate the cells, the water you're drinking is basically a waste of time. That's a proven fact. That's why it's so recent in the Himalayas where the water is the air is way thinner. The water molecules will be smaller, okay, for whatever reason. This is a proven fact. That's why these people that's drinking these waters out there in those areas is living to be 110, okay, some as 130 years old. This is already documented information all over the news or whatever the case is. So nothing, it's not a secret. The reason why, like, people that have bad pain in different areas of their body, when they drink this, the pain is gone. Again, it's reversing the aging process. So all those strength hormones that you need, that your body naturally produce, all right, start producing more of. Not only that, when you have a pain in a certain area, it's cause of the lactic acid, especially when people work out, they be like, oh, I'm sore, my muscle pain, and that's lactic acid building up in the system. So if you have that lactic acid in your system and then you drink this water, we already know this water will neutralize that acid. So when the water neutralizes that acid, pain gone, and that spot could start healing properly on a cellular level, basically cellular rejuvenation. Anything else?
Yes, God. We do have a question coming from 919 area code. 919 family, you have a question or a comment? Okay, while they're getting it together, there was a question in the chat room, brother. They wanted to know what your website or your email address was.
I don't even deal with websites. All right, call me. All right, when I get my website set up, I'm going to set it up in a way where there's no holds barred on there. You could call me 347-595-3847. I'll say it again, 347-595-3847. If you do not get me, okay, you can call me. I'm sorry, leave me a message. If you call me, leave me a message if you don't get me. Now, the reason why certain information that I do not put on websites is because there's a lot of copycatters out there. And when they copycat, they don't even do it right. And then you get a lot of disinformation. So when people, I only do certain things on venues like this because it's all, there's an archive. It's categorized on record that I am the first to say it. So anybody else that comes along and try to copy my style, you're going to know where they got it from. Just like when you hear certain people talk about water and the brain now, you know everything. When they say certain things, you're like, I heard that before. And you could point directly to Mona Harris. Well, that's how it is. When you hear certain things that I give you a breakdown, not just water, but your body and the spirituality down to the aura, whatever the case may be, you could say, I heard that before. Oh, you got that from Joel Benjamin, or however you want to say, Joel Benjamin, Joel Benjamin, whatever. Still my name. Yoel, for the people that, you know, heavily in the Jewish community, they'll tend to say Yoel Benjamin. So regardless of what, that's my name. You know it hurt. You heard it from me. Anything else?
You know it. You know it. We got plenty of questions. Well, you know, as a God, you're going to be inspiring people, God. So area code 205, you have a question or a comment?
Yes. I would like to ask your brother, could he give me any advice, me and my fiance or my wife-to-be are trying to conceive, and could he give me any advice?
Oh, I'll give you more than advice. All right, let me tell you what you got to do. First of all, she needs to cleanse her system. You need to cleanse your system, all right? Y'all can talk to Aline for that. He got some herbs he could give you for that. Second thing, you got to get this water. You will not be able to conceive properly if you don't have the water. I don't know if you eat garbage foods, maybe not. But let's say you use a microwave, and she's using a microwave, and you're using a microwave, stop. Because you're putting radiation in your body. When you put that radiation in your body, you radiate your body, radiate your blood, radiate the water, radiate your brain. That's it. And you're definitely going to radiate your semen, all right? Another thing is you keep them cell phones on your hips. If you haven't got a diode from Dr. Blair, the diodes, then don't put that in your pocket. All right? Just only take a chance. Don't have it attached to your hips or your pockets. Secondly, for her, now, a lot of times there'll be access of yeast there. I know one lady that Paulette actually introduced me to, her and her husband, and a very beautiful lady, all right, older lady, and the husband was there, and they drank the water, and as far as I know, the water did a lot for them, but they wanted to be cheap, and this woman was saying she could not conceive a baby. From the time she told me that, I said, first thing I normally do when a woman tell me that, I blame the man. But then I looked at her, and I noticed she had that little pouch. You know how some women have that little pouch flapping over? I said, guess what? There's two things, all right? Either she has excess liquid in her body she don't need, or she has excess yeast, or yeast period, which shouldn't belong there. As soon as I told her that, she told me straight up and down. She said, listen, brother, I went to this Asian doctor. The Asian doctor checked me out, and he found high levels of yeast. So that baby cannot survive in that environment because the environment is acidic. Mm-hmm. You need it to be alkaline. So you need to start taking these, different methods to change your life. And a lot of it will have to do with stress and what they put in the drinking water, such as anthracene. Remember, you're bathing in it. Your biggest organ or whatever you want to call it on your body is your skin. And it goes through your pores. And it goes through every form of your body. All right? So you got to think.
Right.
Anthracene messes with the hormones. All right? I gave a breakdown, a lecture of that when I opened up for A.A. Rashid. He should have that on his DVD. If you get a chance, check out Brother A.A. Rashid. Big ups to him. All right? So there's stuff I gave breakdown on. Me personally, if you want, you can contact me, and I could tell you how to get a certain drink for me where you could work on that. And you take this how I tell you, you will be good to go. How old are you?
I'm 34.
And how old is she?
She's 34.
All right, 34 and 34. You're already supposed to have problems in that avenue. I'm sure you already know that. So what you need to do is alkalize the body, because I've been responsible for getting women that's 50-something years old pregnant, all right, with certain things that I give them. Okay? You deal with me, you'll be in good order. And also deal with Dr. Aline Bay, because he is amazing when it comes to the Reiki. There's certain breathing you could do to help you get a start out. You understand? A start out.
Sir.
So when you get a chance, check out Dr. Aline Bay with his Reiki. A lot of times, like I said, I know it could also be stress, but from the most part, when I deal with people, it's what they're eating. So first, start off with some Reiki or some type of meditation. Have her do yoga, okay, and her Kegel exercises. You could talk to Dr. Aline Bay's wife about that, Khadija, and they could give you a breakdown. But as for cleansing out the system and all that stuff, talk to me, and certain stuff you could get from Dr. Aline Bay and his wife. I hope I helped you and been informative with that.
Yes, sure have, baby. Appreciate it.
You're welcome.
All right. Thank you, brother. We have a comment or question from area code.
Hold on, Khadija. Hold on, Khadija, before you get that person. Also, because I know the brother is still listening. When you drink this water, it adds proper circulation to your body, all right, which helps blood flow, erection, and vaginal wetness, okay? So once you're in the motion, you have to take your blood is flowing right. First of all, you'll notice it starts cleaning you out. If you get the water first time, just drink a gallon. Shouldn't take you more than a half an hour to just drink that gallon down. Drink that gallon down. When you go to that bathroom, you'll be telling me something. If you don't blow that bathroom up and overflow the toilet with feces, you'll be urinating, and you'll be urinating so much. Some people that used to smoke 20, 30 years ago, when they go urine and defecate, they're telling me the urine and feces smelling like cigarettes, Newports, okay? This is real deal. So when you take this, you get the proper blood flow, you get a harder erection. When you get a harder erection, proper blood flow, proper circulation, the more semen you'll produce. As for her, the more proper blood flow she'll have is the more, how you say, stuff that don't belong in her body will come out of her vaginal area. And she will notice that she'll be extra moist down there, extra wet, when she drinks this water on the regular. And I'm not talking about no wet as in pee. I'm talking about that nice, sticky, icky, gooey stuff. People say I'm graphic, but you got to get graphic. That's the only way you understand, because then when I tell you what it is, when you go and you try it yourself to see what I'm telling you actually work, and I'm not lying to you. Once you have proper circulation and you can clean out the system properly on a cellular level, stuff that people will call miracles will be a regular everyday thing for you. All right, next question.
From the furry cup, be more healing. Okay, brother, thank you for your question. Brother 718, area code 718, you have a comment or a question? Okay, they're not. All right, brother, okay.
So, call it up. I'm going to get me a television. I'm going to get this.
Yes, you building on something. Brother or sister from area code 512.
Oh, peace and respect. How's
yes.
it going?
Great.
Oh, man. I
I didn't think I was going to get on. I was listening the whole time, and I was like, they're not going to pick me. Yeah, this is the first time I've been on. I remember the first time it was like I was watching something with Aleem Bey who was speaking about tantric practices and all that. Man, that was such a long time ago. I was wondering, like, with the water, there's some people have what they call distilled water. Is that something you would want to get? Or, because I have filtered water.
I need you to break down before you say anything else. Distilled water leaches minerals from your bones. If it leaches minerals from your bones, it's going to leach minerals from your organs. That's what distilled water do. All right? Next question.
Right.
I don't even need to tell you that's not good for you. Once I tell you it does that, you make your decision after that. But it will be way better than these other waters. But be warned, it leaches minerals from your bones. That's why they got something that's called smart water out there, which it's acidic. Not only it's acidic, okay, it got a positive ORP range, oxidation reduction potential range, which is no good for you. You need it on a negative scale. So, and it got, what's the stuff they put in it to help it actually be something of substance where they could call it smart is the, electrolytes. That's what it is.
Electrolytes.
Electrolytes that your body should naturally be producing to begin with anyway. All right, next question you got?
Actually, I just have a, I don't mean to take up too much time. I know other people got, so filtered water would also have those acidic properties in them?
Well, you could get a pH test, or you could test it yourself and you'll see, all right? I'll give you a breakdown of what's crazy, because even though the water is alkaline, and it'll show up alkaline, really don't mean much, because over there in Baltimore, Maryland, when I test their water in the pH range, it comes out blue. Blue is on the scale anywhere from 7.9 or 7.8 to an actual 8.5, 8.7, it's pushing it, you know?
Right,
let's
that
just
was
say
the range.
8.9 or 8.0, let's say 8.8. And that water is loaded with tons of stuff, and the ORP level on it is horrible. But on the skin, it's showing up as that. See, they're putting different chemicals in the water now and all these stuff. So, right, okay.
Right.
It's not going to show that, all right, these stuff are in there. It's not going to show that, okay, it is acidic to you. The stuff that's in there is acidic, but it's there and it is. You understand what I'm saying? Because some of these things that's in there, and also in most bottled water, is different microorganisms. You got the reverse osmosis. That don't take out parasites, okay? It takes out many of the inorganic garbage, but it don't take out parasites, all right? So it's like wasting your time on that one.
Man, that's crazy. Well, I was actually sometimes I put like, say baking soda. I heard this
I'm sorry,
remedy.
Repeat that. You take what?
Baking soda in the water, and that will.
Okay.
Will that usually alkaline it?
Yeah, but like I said, again, to a certain degree, you need something stronger. If you have a method where you can get something better to help you and put you to the proper state of mind, body, spirit of well-being you need to be in, then you need to get that. That baking soda is only going to cut it but for so long.
All right. Hey, can I write that down where I can, I want to write that down real quick where I can get this water at. Is that okay?
Again, where are you located?
I'm located in Austin, Texas.
Austin, Texas. All right. I had about I think two people from Texas that bought a machine for me. I'll give you my number again. Take my number down. Tell me when you're ready. Okay. 347-595-3847.
Okay. I got that.
All right.
Anything with finding this type of water?
I don't understand. What's your question? I don't understand.
Well, anything with finding this type of water, this alkaline water that will help circulate the blood flow and everything with the body. Instead of drinking like some of this nasty water that's
drink the water. Once you drink it, you'll see what I'm talking about. Because I could talk and tell you so much stuff about this water. We could have a 4-hour show, no exaggeration. With the information I got, you could have a 4-hour show. But it's nothing
right.
like when you experience for yourself. Nothing like
okay.
it.
Okay, all right. I appreciate that so much, brother, and I didn't mean to take up too much time. This was my first time on the show, so thank you so much.
No problem. You got questions that need to be answered, so.
No doubt. And you didn't take up too much time, and we appreciate you, and I'm glad that you called in, Brother Mike.
All right, no problem. All right, peace and respect.
Peace, man. Have a good one.
That's the next generation right there. I don't know how many times I've heard people say they wish they had the information when they were younger. God is 19. It's beautiful. Okay, we have a question or a comment from area code 786.
Yes, peace and blessings.
Yes, peace and honor, God.
Can you hear me?
Loud and clear.
Okay. Yes, I have a question. In terms to the water or, say, the actual machine, for all the ones that desire to actually get a machine but don't have a full payment, is there options where we can make installments and also reap
yes,
the benefits at the same time?
Plan. There's a payment plan. You pay down on the machine. You get the machine within a week. Depending on the area you live in, because of the taxes.
Dane County, Florida country.
I'm sorry?
Yes, sir, Brother Al Malik, Dane County, Florida country.
Keith?
You in Florida, you said?
Dane County, Florida country. Dane County, South Florida.
Okay. Let me give you a breakdown. In the USA, there's a payment plan, okay? You do a down payment depending on the area you live in. It'll probably be ranged from anywhere from $800 and about $860 down payment, or to $600, maybe $500-something down payment, depending on the area you live and how your tax range is, okay? After you pay that, you get your machine within 1 week. After you get, sometimes 3 days, 3 days to a week. After you get that machine, anywhere from 3 days to a week, all right, you just pay $225 every month. Basically, you have your machine there and you could use it. Just pay it $225 every month, because if you don't, these people want to start coming and get their machine, period.
Okay, now is this the least amount for one machine, or that's it? Is that
the machine is anywhere
from
$4,200, depending on the area you live in. The tax, you might have to pay $4,500, depending on your tax range. All right, that's it, basically, pretty much. So you, whatever your down payment will be, you pay your down payment. All right. Then you get your machine. When you get your machine, you just start the payment plan. want you to payment plan for everywhere is $225 every month. Some people could choose to pay higher a month. It's up to you. They got a plan where you can make your plan pay more than that a month. Some people don't like to go do all that. Some people pay through their 3-month installment. Some people do the 10-month one. Some people do the 6 months. It's all up to you. Because some people don't like going.
Okay, so I can just go ahead and call you later and I can get the breakdown of the specifics.
Yeah, just call me when you're ready. I'll break down, go online, take your address, check out out of tax range, whatever it is, you know, the basics. And I set it up and you get your machine. It's that easy. It's not difficult. There's no excuse. For anybody that ain't have any excuses, there really is none. Because I'm watching people that come to this country, don't speak no English, and they walk up to that office and they get a machine. They sell the water back or they sell the machine back or however they do it. They flip it. When 3 months they speak in English better, they drive in a nice vehicle. When you see them in a year time, they speak in full English. They pockets is fat. They drive in a great vehicle. And they most of the stuff they claim it on taxes. So let me tell you something.
Okay. All right. What's that number? 347-595-3847 is correct?
Correct. My name is Joel Benjamin.
Okay, brother. I will be in contact. Peace and blessings, everyone. Peace out.
All right. Peace.
Okay.
All right, let me see. Okay, the family want to know, what's the name of the machine? Now, this is the chat room. The question is, what's the name of the machine?
E-Magic, SD501. Most of
okay.
the information I'll give you about the machine, you ain't going to find online, so don't waste your time. I know other people don't listen, and then they end up calling my phone. And I was like, Plumper, you're right. I'm not getting most of the information you're saying. I was like, I already told you, don't waste your time. So call me, give you the information you need to know, because in Japan, again, they're allowed to say that this machine cures diseases. In Japan, they're allowed to say this. Over here in America, this machine is called a water device. Over in Japan, the machine is called a medical device. So, go figure. You got the FDA and FTC to thank for that over here in America.
Well, their business is not about caring, especially not us, and that's why when you get on radio shows, you get cut off, you know? We would like to do another commercial. Basically, it's an upcoming event. We're waiting on the goddess Deborah to press one. Okay, please, goddess. You're live and in living color.
Oh, good night, listeners. Good night, Dr. Ellen Bay. Good night, Khadijah. Good night, Joelle. Thank you for this insightful show so far. I'm really enjoying it.
Good night. I'm glad you're enjoying it.
Yeah, basically, at this point in time, I'd like to inform the listeners about a special or an imperative event that's taking place. It's taking place, actually, November 13th. That's this Sunday in Brooklyn, New York, New York City. Basically, this author, his name is Dr. Michael Tordeson, and he has composed an astounding book called The Invisible Jim Crow. This event will be held at Restoration Plaza in New York City, November 13th, Sunday at 1368 Fulton Street, Brooklyn, New York. And the contact number is 718-789-3264. Once again, author Dr. Michael Tollison is giving a wave of his book called The Invisible Jim Crow, and basically he's going to spread the word about his book and its insightful meanings and its purpose, and basically it's about how conservative forces have moved to deny African Americans their equal rights to power, wealth, and knowledge.
Major guidance. Thank you so much for that.
And thank you. And the mission is only $7, so please come out and attend the event. It's Restoration Plaza, 1368 Fulton Street, 5th floor, Brooklyn, New York. Contact number is 718-789-3264. Thank you so much.
Powerful, invisible Jim Crow laws. Be
That's
there,
correct.
Family, or be square. Thank you so much, Goddess, and you have a great night.
You too. Thank you.
Who's motherfucking ass? We want you to put your phone on mute. Any other questions, family? Press 1. Press 1, family, if you have any more comments or any more questions.
All right. Let me say real quick. I've been getting a lot of people asking me questions, like with other people, water, and they have different machines and whatnot, you know, like the distillers, the ozonators, and all these different type of Brita filters and all these. Again, if it's not going directly to the cell, you're wasting your time. I'm going to keep on saying it probably to, no, I ain't saying it till I'm blue in the face because I ain't holding my breath. I'm going to talk on it. You're wasting your time, okay? Now, if you're in an area, let's say that ozonator, the ozonated water, or however the case may be, yeah, it's good, okay, but how much of it you really got to drink before you start seeing results, all right? It's not going directly to your cell, okay? Distilled water could be good to a certain point, but it releases minerals from your bones. So there's a lot of things out there that people just got to learn and understand. You got the reverse osmosis. You got all these different type of machines, but you're not getting the supreme results. Now, people will say, well, what's the difference from buying yours? I could just buy a cheap machine. That's the problem with most of these damn people, that they need to get to they got to get this thing out of their skull and really realize you go cheap, you get what you pay for. Now, people are like, well, what were your benefits on your machine that you deal with? First of all, I deal with the company at Magic, but I'll tell you like it is. If they don't care about me, I don't care about them, but I won't throw the baby out with the bathwater. I know a lot of people hear me say that. They're the best when it comes to dealing with these things. And all these other companies that make these things really are supposed to pay them money because they have the patent for the technology and the breakdown, okay? And any one of them, companies that's not paying them, they got to go to them. I'm sorry, if a Natchez finds out, they step to them, guess what? They got to pay them. And most people don't know the filters that they make, all right? Other people with their machines are using the filters, they buy it from Natchez, all right? Now, my homeboy, which had somebody that worked for Natchez that makes the filters and put them together, went to a different company, and they order the parts and everything from Natchez. So you do the math on that. When it comes to the filter, as for the machine, different story, all right? That's why most of those machines, you could take the Enagic filter and put it in there because it's the same science, but they're not telling you that. And these people, machines will break down, whatever the case may be, blah, 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 and people are spending money for it. It's like you got Air Force One, all right? You both fly, but you're in luxury. You got three flights. Let's say you got three flights upstairs in a plane, believe it or not, let's just say, okay? Then you got flares. If missiles come at you, it shoots out the flares, the whole nine yards. Air Force One is decked out, okay? Now, you get from anywhere, let's just say, they get from New York to Washington, D.C. on Air Force One in, let's say, 10 to 15 minutes. That's how fast it is. Now, you got the regular airline with the coach seats or whatever, you get on that plane, a regular plane, and it's flying you from New York to D.C., and it's taking 3 hours. See the difference? So you're paying for perfection. And that's just the bottom line. Any other questions?
I definitely address, because I think everything happens for a reason. Most oftentimes people get into arguments or have a negative disposition because they're dehydrated. The brain, the womb, the spine, all of these major organs, they have to have water that they can utilize, that the water clusters are small enough to ingest. So it'll definitely cut out on the arguments and, you know, and the stress and the strain in the home. Definitely. Also, too, just an algorithm in order to help the family think of this. This machine, yes, is $4,000, but you're definitely worth that. And you can break it down to a nice pair of shoes, some Tim's, the Xbox, and two games. That's the down payment. And then $225 a month, we already spend that bottled water. We already spend that on bottled water monthly. And also, too, just to give a breakdown, I remember one brother who has a cheap machine. He went cheap, and it became detrimental to his nervous system. So, you know, when you go cheap, you know, you get what you pay for. And then you have the machine paid for after 16 months. So it definitely pays for itself. It's a wonderful investment. Joelle, you have any more comments, any more questions, God?
Well, like I said, I ain't telling nothing to nobody that want to go cheaper again. That's their problem. Because at the end of the day, I do what I do, and I do it well. The information I give, I make sure I give it well. There's certain shows or whatever the case is, I don't even bother going. But when I leave, say, yo, I need you, I'm there. You understand what I'm saying? Our next one is Noble Park. If he calls, I'm there. So these are people I deal with because they show that they're genuine. And this day and age, you're not meeting a lot of people that are genuine. You're meeting a lot of people that's trying to mislead you, especially misleading you for that dollar. All right? Again, you have other people, they'll put down the monatomic gold, which people was using for years, and most of the monatomic gold comes from Egypt. And they'll tell you, oh, my time to go is bad for you, this, that, da, 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 da. But yet you got Caucasians giving the breakdown on how good it is and what it does to the brain and what it will do for people of melanated descent, highly melanated descent. And the same goes for the water. I find that strange. None of these people is talking this thing. As soon as you start coming out in the open and saying certain things, they want to push themselves in the forefront just because they got a large base. And if the people are idiots and fools, they're going to follow them instead of just like, I have my homeboy, Roger. Big up to Roger. Got my partner. We make many inventions together. We do a lot of things. That's my homeboy right there. And he says straight up, let the people try this water for 1 week. And after they try it for 1 week, then come back and say something. I told him straight up, no, let him try it for 1 day. And then let them tell me something. You understand what I'm saying? But most of these people won't do it. They'll go. They'll just run their mouth. And they will lose the benefits. And then when other people start getting into this field and doing what they got to do, you'll start seeing the hate and envy come when this stuff ends up in a big way, when they could have been got aboard and be down with it. So you have to watch out for these people that's pushing alkalinity, and all of a sudden, they don't want to push the alkalinity no more. What's going on? There's a problem. Start looking at these people as suspects. All right? There's a few people out there that are suspects. Some of them know Mona Harris, and they won't even ever mention Mona Harris. All right? Because they're too damn scared. Okay? They're scared. And that's basically it, bottom line.
Well, see, the wonderful thing is that the next generation, because our melanin is constantly changing, you know, we don't have that type of fear. You know, so they can be scared. They can go to church. But we're going to recognize that the temple of God is within. And, you know, we're going to flow with that. Ain't nobody going to be scared here. We have a comment. Well, we have a question.
Oh, I'm sorry. Go ahead.
Well, I was just gonna take a comment or question, God, but please add on.
No. Bring the comment and question, and I'll say what I gotta say after, because I'm about to go in again. Go ahead.
Okay, absolutely. Peace, peace, God. How you doing?
How you doing,
I'm
sister?
I'm great.
That's good. I'm just sitting here soaking up the information. Well, I'd just like to ask the brother, is there anything that can this particular water help kidney problems?
All right. I'm going to break it down to you like this. I ain't allowed to say cures, but read between the lines. In Japan, all right, it's had people with kidney problems, okay, all type of organ problems. They got people that was going to get their foot cut off from diabetes, and they use this machine because the machine also makes seven different type of waters. I ain't even go into that yet with the strong acidic water that it uses, which when you in Japan, they're allowed to say it heals up cuts, burns, and bruises, okay? They're allowed to say that. Kills Salmonella and E. coli on contact. Now, for your question, simply put, in Japan, yes, they say it. It does that, okay?
Okay, okay. I appreciate it. My mother's suffering with kidney failure, and she's on dialysis. And the brother and sister are familiar on who I am. I'll probably be calling you. My name is Dwayne Waters, and peace and love to the family.
Okay, I'll be looking up that call.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
Now, family, Joel loves us so much that he's going to also put some of these bells underneath me. Thank you so much, Joel.
Well, that ain't no problem. That's why I gave them the number, because they could contact you and, like, whatever they don't understand, you refer them to me and I'll explain them or you do a three-way, however you want. And it's no problem with me. You get the sale because you win, I win. Paulette win, I win. I win, you all win. That's how we do it here. Because there's one thing I noticed, and I must say, that Zeke Rewards, all right, and the stuff with the gold and silver, I don't know how often y'all get into that, but I guarantee you, every chance you get on the radio show, you got to get into it because people, it works. You ain't got enough money for your machine, let Khadijah flip that money for you. Give her $20. Just give her $20 a month and watch the wonders she works for you with Deep Rewards. By the time she's done, probably in about 3 months, you're able to buy four machines, and I'm not exaggerating.
Wow, I'm over here cheesing God. As a matter of fact, one of the brothers was just saying, thank you so much, God, for looking out on the Zeke Rewards. Fam, that's powerful. It's a compounding system. Y'all can go back to the archives and check it out. We also get
tell
together.
Tell them about the gold. Hold on. Tell them about the gold. That's my favorite thing. The gold and silver thing, that's my favorite thing because also, you know, speaking of gold and silver, since we're speaking about quote-unquote precious metals, a lot of people don't know this machine has platinum-coated plates in it, all right? So people talking about, well, the price. Remember, this has platinum-coated titanium plates. So those are two precious metals you got there, platinum and titanium, all right?
Mm-hmm.
Don't forget to create the synergy with the magnets, all right, when it has the certain polarities that separate the garbage out the water, giving you the clean water and ionizing water, breaking up the microclusters. Please don't forget that. So people, talk to Khadijah when you got a chance about that gold and silver, because when she talked to me about that, I jumped on that right away, and it's legit.
Yeah, absolutely. Get with me on that. Now, God, the Kendra water machine has seven plates in it. Could you, like, break it down? Are all of them titanium or all of them platinum?
All of them are seven platinum-coated titanium plates, okay? Now, it have one with 12 plates, all right? As a friend of mine, Jamel, he's in the business, too. He got into it, you know, through me, and he calls it the big boy. And this sucker is more for commercial use, but people use the regular SD501 for commercial use. The one that with the 12 plates is called the Super SD501, all right? Now, a lot of people will be like, well, I want that one. I want that one. Basically, I could take people money and be like, yeah, take that one. Because, of course, if I'm selling it to you, I'll get a commission or whatever the case may be. But that ain't the point. The point is, if you tell me how your lifestyle is, I could say, okay, get this one. And most people, they get the SD501. And if you got that stylish titanium kitchen, you could get the SD501 Platinum. All right? So I work with people, and I let people know I'm honest with people, all right? But if you have a commercial business and you really want to pump out the water like that, it'll be in your best interest to get the big boy. That one should cost you about $5,800 max. It really is not that much when you really think of it. And, of course, they got the payment plan, too, and all that. So, like I said before, people ain't got no excuse. They ain't have no excuse. Because you can say, well, I got bills, this, that, that, yeah, we all got bills, whatever. And you're going to the hospital, you're going to spend more running to the hospital every time, especially if you ain't got a job with proper benefits. You ain't telling me, I'm telling you. You're going to run to those hospitals. And when you got them bills, you better pay them bills or they're going to start garnishing your wages. Khadija and Aileen at the school, you do that. But then again, if you got a job or whatever the case is, they trying to hear none of that. They snatch the check. You got to fight to get it back. Now, if you got the time and money and effort to pay to fight to get it back, all right, you could have done that your machine to keep you out of that hospital, all right. So, again, that's what they say in Japan. Because remember, in Japan, this machine is a medical device and they're allowed to say it cures diseases. That's all I'm saying.
Yeah, we appreciate how you say it. It's the truth. Now, God, I'm messed up about the parasites in the bottled water. Come on, I know you touched on it, but you didn't emphasize
all right,
it
all
enough.
Right. Real quick, let me give you a breakdown. Before I even got into water, in a whole, like, real deal, like, breaking down these stuff, because a lot of the information that I got, most people, it takes them 20 years to get. Some of the information I got, I just flipped on the computer or go get a book from a library, Barnes & Noble, and the information just pop out at me. So I got to really thank my ancestors and the Most High for that, because there is a force that's really driving me to do this. But these parasites, I remember since 2003, 2004, all right? This is before I even got into these water thing and everything, before I got into any of this. There was on Channel 7 News, I never forget it, when the Jewish community was in an uproar. Because they were saying those bottled waters are not kosher because it got two microorganisms in the water, and the government know about it, and they released a statement saying, oh, it's harmless. And those Jews, the Hasidic Jews and all of them over there in Crown Heights and all over New York, they wasn't trying to hear it. They was not having it. Poland Spring was not coming off the shelf. Their pork or none of those bottled waters, all right? They was buying filters, and they was buying the wrong filters until they ran into somebody like me to help them out, and then they start buying the right filters or start buying the right type of water. You understand where I'm coming from? So this is a proven fact. This stuff been said, been out, people just don't know. And look at the breakdown I gave you with the water turning red and it's raining red liquid. How much people actually heard about this? This stuff's been happening since 2000, 2001. It only really started getting, media coverage 2006, okay? How much people know about that? Any questions anybody got on that, by the way? So that's short. Got a few people got questions on that. Hello?
Yes, hello, God. It does look like we may have a comment or a question from area code 904.
Yes, this is Shay. My question is, do y'all
know anything. I don't know if it's happening up north, but I know in the south, they're actually forced. I'm not sure about the whites, but they're forcing it on you that your baby has to get a shot.
Well, honestly, guys,
baby, shot, and I don't like it. I really want to find a way to fight this thing.
Well, it's easy, guys.
Injection? You talking about vaccines?
Yeah, I don't see no reason for it to take people out.
All right, for my lady, I made up a form. All right, is a little.
That's easy to make manifest. All you need is a vaccine exemption form. You also need to find out in your territory where they're going to honor your philosophical, your medical, or your religious beliefs. And that's easy to remedy. Get it notarized and it's done. Joelle, you wanted to add on?
Yeah, because I made the form and it worked because she's going to college, it worked. Her daughter's going to school, PS school. They just took it. They didn't even do no argument, and that was that. I also gave it to another lady where the judge was saying, oh, she was evil for not giving her children vaccines, blah, blah, blah. Gave her that form. All that was put to rest. They got shut down.
Yeah,
quick.
They got them so scared here, though. In the South, they're terrified. Well, if I don't let the baby get a shot, they say they'll cut off my, you know what I'm saying? So
They tried to use fear tactics because at Nicholas Bookstore over there in Brooklyn, downtown Brooklyn, Sister Monique, big up to her, I did a lecture there where I opened for a guy who was doing vaccines. King Simon put that together. You could contact him to get that guy's book, which deals with vaccines and certain forms or whatever. I did a lecture there, and I gave a breakdown, same with the water, but I went even further because what a lot of guys, like Khadija say, that's easy to handle. What a lot of people don't know, and this was on History Channel, Discovery, you could check this out. They have it where they could now they use scalar weaponry, where they could put the vaccine in a Petri dish. All right, this is crazy. Check this information out, people. Go to your libraries. Ask for the official government documents. You could put it up online, go to the government website. It's not hard to find. They'll put the vaccine in the Petri dish, and they send out the wave of that vaccine, and you could get the vaccine, the symptoms of that vaccine. Another thing they do where they, and I watched this myself on the History Channel, they were breeding the mosquito larvae in the vaccine liquid. So the mosquitoes is born with the vaccines, and when they bite you, you get the vaccine in your system. This is crazy what I saw. So a lot of people scared that way. They know people are using the way how me and Khadija just told you. They're like, no, these suckers going to get it. They even got it so advanced. And all this I watched on History Channel, I wish I remembered the name of that documentary. But like I said, this information I'm telling you ain't hard to find. Just go type it up. Go to your library. You're going to get it. They got so advanced. If you have sex with your mate, if you kiss your mate, as a matter of fact, if you're next to somebody in the train, they cough, they sneeze, you get the vaccine airborne. And as far as I know, that was it in that
so
guy's
what,
book.
So what site to look it up? I mean, so let me write this down.
Guys, all you got to do is type in vaccine exemption form, and everybody named mama finna give you a sample, and then you get it notarized, use two witnesses, and take it to the baby school. They're going to honor it. But see, down south, they play on people's ignorance. So, this is easy to remedy,
guys.
Oh, my God,
yes.
This is easy to remedy.
All right. Also, if you want to get most of these vaccines, because I know for a fact people that have drunk this water, the hepatitis B vaccine and all these other vaccines came out their system. Because remember, it's a virus they put in your system to begin with. It don't belong there. And they've drunk this water, and it cleaned their system right up. That's a proven fact. All right? Just for people that have took these vaccines before and they notice they have all kind of complications and they need to get their body in order, then they need to drink some of these, some of this water, and they'll see what I'm working with. Anything
okay,
else, ma'am?
Earlier in the show, you were talking about the connection between water and melanin. You said that you were going to go further in, so that's what we would love to hear. You go further in.
All right. Everybody know water and melanin goes together. They've been doing heavy research, all right, the U.S. government. Matter of fact, let me just make it plain. All governments have been doing heavy research on the alkalinity of proper ionized water, all right, and melanin, because the negative ions give your brain a jolt. So people who have calcified pineal glands, the pineal glands started to decalcify. Decalcify, because the pineal glands was calcified before. So once that calcification starts coming off, is because of the flow of the alkalinity of the proper water that was getting into their body. Again, water and melanin goes together. Some people, and I've said this before and I'm going to say it again, some people drink this water and even notice they start getting some color. That's because their pineal gland is becoming properly activated. Okay? Once that starts happening, they got people that drink this water. Sometimes they say they can't sleep because they got so much energy, all right? And then when they do get to sleep, they get a good night's rest, wake up, and they're fine, okay? Now, a lot of people, they drink this water, and they said, I never slept so good like that in a long time. Why? Because you're producing the proper amount of melanin, okay? Some people tell me how their dreams are off the chain. I know personally when I drink a lot of that water during the day, I go to bed, it's a wrap. The dream cycles is on, straight realm. All right? You be in a realm straight state and you're good to go. Okay? There was one more thing I was going to tell you with the melanin. Okay, yes. Anybody that want to put me to this test and challenge me on this, get this water. If you get a chance, you can call me, and I can link you to my homeboy, Roderick, and Roderick can give you certain information on where you could use this water. And when you use this water, for people who are raw vegan, okay, and he could tell you certain ways how to make your raw vegan meals using this water, because Roderick is a raw veganist, okay, and he could give you a breakdown. And also, you'll see a difference on your dreams. But people who eat meat, I would advise you when you're cooking your meat, stewing or whatever, you use this water because it neutralizes a strong amount of the acid that's in the meat. That's why when people is eating this meat, they got people that eat cheeseburger, chili dogs, all this type of garbage, but they drink in the water. You got to at least drink a gallon a day if you're going to eat that bad. Okay? They drink a gallon of that water, and they're fine. They go to the bathroom normal, pass out whatever they got to pass out, and they're good to go. That's because they're getting the proper water. I said the last time on the show, it's just like an aquarium. You keep that filthy water in there, the water gets stinked, old, it looks nasty, the fishes are going to die. You clean it out properly, your shelves properly, it's going to be a more rejuvenation and a proper environment. It's just like a fish tank. It sells it just like a fish tank. Anything else?
Hello?
Can you hear me, guys?
Yeah, I hear you.
Okay, great. If there's any other comments, questions, please press 1. Joelle, the spirit leading you to say anything else?
Yeah, I'm good. Next time you need me on, I drop some more information on you. More about that red liquid because a lot of people need to know about that red liquid. That's very important.
Well, God, if you're impelled to do so, we still got another 40 minutes. It's up to you. Next time, this time, it's up to you.
No. Nope, because this the people that the time is already up, right? So the people that's on the radio, sorry, not the radio, on the internet won't be able to hear it right now. Am I correct?
No, they're still on there.
I'm talking about for the internet. As far as I know, it's a cutoff time. The people online are able to hear it. So I want to do it when everybody is able to hear and available so I could give the breakdown to the science.
Absolutely. And you've already filled us so much today with mental thoughts. So I'm full. It's late.
I hope I've been informative and I've helped a lot.
You have.
You heard me?
You really have.
Okay.
You know I did.
Very good.
And we appreciate you. We appreciate you so much, God. You're the truth. You're the truth.
Thank you. I just want to say again, for a lot of people that's paying attention to what's going on, I always make sure I push this lecture because it's very important that people get it. It's Eileen Bay's Weather Wars, Part 1 and 2, because with the breakdown I got next time, I'm going to give the breakdown on the same harp system and how it's changing the effects of the environment, okay? And, of course, if it's changing the effects of the environment, causing earthquakes, tornadoes, and tsunamis, all these things have a correlation to do with water. There's a reason why these sharks, whales, and all these dolphins are beaching themselves, penguins, you know, coming up on certain parts of the land where it's so dry, like they don't even have the sense to go back in the water. That's because it's something that the frequency is sending out, and it's changing the different neuron pathways of the body, or should we just say the brain, okay? And it's messing up the water, all right? Not just the water that's in the ocean, but the water that's in the actual animal's brain, also the people. So if it's powerful to do that, we have to start learning ways to counter it. The best way I know to counter it is take good water in your system and also deal with certain crystals. So next time I'll get more into that so that everybody can hear and get a proper breakdown of everything that's going on.
That sounds like a plan, God. That sounds like a plan. You know, this is for the brothers that's in the Dismal Crypts. And, you know, next lecture, next Blog Talk Radio show, we need to break down the prison bonds and nationality and birthright. We need to revisit that. Thank you, Joelle. Thank you, everybody, for listening. And we'll see you next Wednesday on the Eileen Bay Show.
First World Order Radio, finally, we are on the air. No doubt. All right.
There's always going to be somebody in the building on First World Order Radio.
We get on into some of that order consciousness tonight.
First World Order Radio every Wednesday, 8 p.m.
We got to talk about what is taking place on the planet.
There's always going to be somebody in the building on First World Order Radio. First, we need to let you know we're going to be doing more shows, giving out more information on Wednesdays. Wednesday at 8 o'clock, we are now going to make this is the hottest day of the week.
Preceding others in time, order, importance. The most prominent parts, voices, or instruments. Earthly state of human concerns and existence. An indefinite multitude, quantity, or distance. System regulates to bring about specifics in the group based on value and natural characteristics. Current radiates electromagnetistics of sound through the air, same as your thoughts transmits it. Burn. Preceding others in time, order, importance. The most prominent parts, voices, or instruments.
Burn.
Earthly state of human concerns and existence. An indefinite multitude, quantity, or distance.
Order.
System regulates to bring about specifics in the group based on value and natural characteristics.
Radio.
Current radiates electromagnetistics of sound through the air, same as your thoughts transmits it.
You need to understand how magical this, something like this every Wednesday can become. So
So you need to start getting your calendar right, get your schedule right. You need to know our intention straight out.
All right, so, these clues are given throughout the various languages for us to piece the puzzle of this ancient mystery school back together again.
And what we plan on doing, both of us, is bringing y'all some surefire dynamite. We're going to take this level up a notch. We're going to have stuff to do here. This is not just going to be about philosophies and theories, shit that works.